Hi there. As of the 3rd of February 4/13, the website has turned two years since the website first launched. And to commemorate this, we're doing a best of feature for the next hour on 4/13. Now, first of all, before we continue, let me just also welcome our new viewers from Daily Motion, which we've now launched on as the channel. Just search Daily Motion 4/13 on the extension to the end of the link there, just as it is on YouTube. We'll be operating on both of those accounts, as well as on the social network sites as well, Facebook and Twitter. 4/13 now has 5 separate outlets where we'll be updating you with information about all the current tropical cyclones out there in the world.
For those new to the 4/13 project, who are you?
Well, that's an interesting question, isn't it? Who am I? My name is Nathan Foy, and I've been working on the 4/13 project ever since it started, because I made it. I'm based here in the UK, so I also do music. I create all the musical compositions on 4/13. I do the animating, graphics, that sort of thing, basic website design, as well as sometimes do some writing, which is obviously very useful when you're writing up about storms. So I've dabbled a little bit in sort of journalistic tendencies, let's say. And something else that I do, which I've forgotten to mention, and I was going to mention, but I forgot, so we'll come back to that later.
So if you're based in the UK, why do you work on tropical weather?
Obviously up here in the UK, we've never ever had a hurricane, which is rather strange. I know we've had lots of extratropical storms and the like, but never a single hurricane or tropical system. So why on earth do I work on tropical cyclones? And really, it's just a personal interest, to be quite honest. I've no links with anyone who lives in these tropical regions, at least not until I started the project. So no background, no history, but they're just extremely fascinating to watch, especially hurricanes, cyclones, typhoons, that sort of thing. Very interesting to watch, fascinating, and of course, obviously very devastating as well as they can be.
How did this all start then?
So it started basically just an experiment. The first animation I ever made was in September 2010, when I started out just on a very basic map with very basic icons and all that sort of stuff, and put it online, and I wondered how it would do. And at worst, if people didn't really like it, then that's just another experiment that went wrong. But as it turned out, some people did like it, and I continued with it, and it evolved from there. And over 3 years, nearly four now, well, 3.5 years, it's grown quite considerably.
How many people work on 4/13?
Quite often. You would expect sort of a small team to work on the sort of things that I do, but it's just me alone. All that I have is some people who help me out in these sort of projects with the filming, and Martin helping me out by asking the questions, which I have to answer. But apart from that, it's just me alone with the website and the video. So quite often I get a bit stretched, so I'm not always doing the best in uploading, because I'm quite overworked, but I have a personal life as well, so that can't be helped. But there are also ways that you can help out the 4/13 project too. If there's anything in particular you're interested in, you can always send an email and see if there's anything that you can do for us.
Finally, what's the future of 4/13?
The future? It's a difficult question, as it usually is when you're asking about the future, because no one knows what the future holds. I was considering ending the project in May this year, but it doesn't look as likely now, because of recent developments that have occurred, a little bit of press coverage here and there as well. So it's given me a little more motivation to continue. So we might continue beyond May into the summer, but that does mean I'd be committed till December. That's just the personal commitment that I'd have to do, really, because I don't want to abandon halfway through a season. But as it is, there'll probably be a little less work going on throughout the summer, but I'll still be around. And that's what will be going on in the future of 4/13. Hopefully we'll still continue to get better and bigger and better. And if there's other people working on the project too, we could consider more means to expand. As for myself, maybe a job in broadcasting would be nice one day. If anyone's out there looking for someone who would like to do some, who could do that sort of thing, then please look at me. Is that a good enough advert?
I think that's a good enough
idea. I'm advertising myself now, you see.
Okay.
All right, end it.
That was very good.
Now don't turn it, end it.
I don't know how to.
The first hurricane season, chronologically, was the 1780 hurricane season, which featured the Great Hurricane, which is what most people would know about. This video was uploaded in 2013. This was followed by the 1837 Atlantic hurricane season, which featured a number of storms, strong storms indeed, that made landfall. And then we had the 1851 hurricane season. Now it's worth pointing out that all seasons before this time were not particularly accurate, only based off shipping reports or personal accounts. But from 1851 onwards, they were a little bit more accurate and complete. This video was uploaded August 2013. Skipping a few decades, we had the 1899 hurricane season, which featured a few storms making landfall, a particularly strong one being Tropical Cyclone No. 3, which was the San Ciriaco hurricane, which struck Puerto Rico. It was also pretty much the longest storm to last in the Atlantic. This video was less recent, uploaded in March 2013. And then the 1914 Atlantic hurricane season, which was pretty well boring, let's say. The only storm to form was this Tropical Storm 1, and that's why we don't really have to speed up this video, because pretty much the whole of it is included in this best of feature. But for such a boring season, it was somehow one of the most popular, with nearly 4,000 views. A lot of these older seasons have really faded into irrelevance, to be quite honest, because they were so long ago, but the 1949 was one of those that still features some rather intense landfalls, like the one you just saw there in the past few seconds. This video was uploaded in January 2013. Now in 1950, Atlantic cyclones were named for the first time, this using the military alphabet of the time. This season featured 10 hurricanes, 7 of those being major hurricanes. Force 13 did two versions of this animation, this being the newest looking. This one was uploaded in August 2013. And now onto the 1964 West Pacific typhoon season, which was the busiest on record ever, and that in turn makes it the busiest season on record anywhere in the world, in any basin. This was featured at the end of Hurricane Week 2012, so it's a little bit more dated, but you can still see the main aim and most of the features are still there. This was followed by the 1965 West Pacific typhoon season, which also featured a few intense storms and landfalls alike. This was featured at the end of Hurricane Week 2013, one of the five featured seasons that were shown throughout the feature in late November. Then we had the 1969 hurricane season, which of course featured Hurricane Camille, which made landfall as a Category 5 storm in Mississippi. There were also two versions of this video created by Force 13, this being the newer one, uploaded in June 2013. Force 13 has done animations of pretty much every basin around the world that experiences tropical cyclones, and the Eastern Pacific is no exception, with a few to its name. This one was 1985, another one of the featured seasons from Hurricane Week 2013. And 1992 was the busiest of the bunch in the Eastern Pacific, featuring a few intense storms and of course two particular hurricanes, Iniki, which made landfall in Hawaii, probably the strongest landfalling storm in recorded history there, and caused quite significant damage on some of the western islands. And we also had Hurricane Ikika at the very start of the season, most notable for forming in January in the Central Pacific, which is very rare. Meanwhile, in the Southern Hemisphere, everything flips over, including the format of the animation. This was the 1993/4 season in the Southern Indian Ocean, including featuring a few storms, including Geralda, a particularly strong cyclone that made landfall in Madagascar, amongst other storms too that season. This was another of the five that featured in Hurricane Week 2013. Now the Western Pacific is usually busy with storm activity, but 1994 was one of the busiest in recent times, with 34 named cyclones. not quite reaching the heights of 1964, which had 39, but still a significant season nonetheless. This was also on Force 13, uploaded in August 2013. And then on to the 1995 Atlantic Hurricane season. This is version 2, there were two of them, uploaded by Force 13, this one being the latest, uploaded in Hurricane Week 2013, one of the featured five seasons. Of course, this one featured a few intense storms and landfalls, and effectively kicked off the active period that we would experience for over 15 years. The other side of the world was active as ever at the same time, 1995, in the Western Pacific, featured a number of storms, of course, and a few strong landfalls, including the one of Angela making landfall in the Philippines as a Category 5 storm. This video was uploaded in June 2013. And now to the 1997/8 Southern Pacific Cyclone season. Of course, in the Southern Hemisphere, their summer often spans 2 years. This one featured two Category 5 storms simultaneously. There they are, Susan and Ron. This video was uploaded as part of Hurricane Week 2013, another of the five that were featured in that compilation. And now the 1998 hurricane season. Now the first one was loaded years ago, so it looks quite old, and this is the new revitalized version, uploaded in December 2013, featuring one or two new features which may or may not return. This season also saw Hurricane Mitch, which struck Central America as a Category 5 storm initially, but weakened as it stalled offshore Central America, causing a lot of damage there. And now the 2003 hurricane season, amongst the most modern of animations from Force 13. This season featured a few intense storms, including Fabian as appearing there, and Isabel, which followed in its footsteps, and of course struck the United States as a Category 2 cyclone after being a Category 5 for a time. As of January 2014, this, as you see it here, is the newest format of the animations. This was followed by the 2004 season, featuring such storms as Ivan, which was a Category 5 storm throughout that season, reaching wind speeds of 165 miles per hour. This video was uploaded in May 2013. Whilst the Atlantic was going mad that year, the 2005 Pacific hurricane season was a little bit more subdued, but still featured one or two strong storms. This video was uploaded in May 2013. To 2009 in the West Pacific. Now this season was most notable in the Philippines, where we had one storm after another, Quetzana, Parma, and then Melor, all having a part to play in the Philippines, possibly with Lupit as well later on in the season. But Parma in particular stalled over the Philippines before moving over the South China Sea. This video was uploaded in May 2013. And now we have 2012 in the Atlantic. Whilst not the busiest season, quite a memorable one. First of all with Nadine, a very long living storm, but not causing much damage. But then we had, of course, Sandy at the end of the year, which really caused devastation along the eastern coast of the United States. This video was uploaded in early 2013. Finally on our featured list, the 2013 Pacific Typhoon season, which featured quite a lot of storms that made landfall and caused billions of dollars in damages, a few of those Category 5 storms as well. But of course, 2013 cannot be mentioned without the appearance of Typhoon Haiyan, the most strongest storm to make landfall anywhere in the world. This video was uploaded at the end of 2013. Now the full season animations have evolved quite a lot since they first came into operation. The first animation ever was September the 17th, 2010, and over the years, this is 2011 now, you can see how the quality improves pretty much without relent as each animation goes by, introducing the landfall dots in the 1996 season, as well as the new maps which came in at five different intervals. There are five maps that were used throughout the course of the Force 13 animations, and they were eventually replaced in the end by the virtual Earth looking type imagery that you see at the end of this little loop of videos here, like this one, which is pretty much photorealistic except for the sea. Here's a list of all the seasons Force 13 has animated in the real world, every single season that we've ever done on the channel. If you'd like to suggest one to animate, or request it rather, please do feel free to do so, and it will be pushed towards the top of the priority list.
Nathan Foy is here. Now, if you don't know anything about Nathan, we'll tell you a little bit about him. He's a broadcaster, musician, composer, man of many talents, doing everything. He's been doing some stuff with BBC Manchester, BBC Northwest Tonight. He's been behind the scenes there. He's a presenter with LDOK in Salford. And basically, Big H interviewed you a little while ago, didn't he? Am I right?
Yeah.
And you told him all about what you was doing and what was happening and everything else. Just for the people out there, just go into a little bit more about what you do. It's all to do with the weather, isn't it?
That's right.
Okay, just tell us a bit more about that.
Well, first of all, I'd like to point out that all those talents of mine were written down, and because I can't think of them myself.
Right, okay.
but let's go on to what I do. Basically, it's tracking stuff like tropical cyclones.
Right.
I do UK weather on the side as well, but the main feature of what I do is tracking things like hurricanes and stuff like that as they form and strike areas, and try to offer a service. And I've been doing this on the website. It's called Force 13. I've been doing that for, it'll be 2 years since the launch on February the 3rd. And what I'm doing for it is a special video which will feature all the best of what I've done over the past 2 or so years.
Marvellous. And that's why we're being videoed this afternoon, isn't it?
Pretty much, yes.
Pretty much. You're not going to end up on Crime Watch, me, am I?
There's a camera on the side of the studio here filming what's going on.
All right, brilliant. So you've set up you've got all this website and everything now, haven't you?
That's right.
Tell us more about the website.
So the website shows you, it has all sorts of things to do with tropical cyclones, you can track them on there.
Yep.
And I also do videos as well showing all these things, showing and quite often it's not just current storms that I do, it's things in the past as well, and some of it which may apply to us as well. I do some UK forecasting, doing some forecasting for the next few days on there when I get the chance to, but mainly it's the tropical cyclones which I do on there. And have been doing the videos a little bit longer than the website,
right?
But the website's been going for 2 years, and that's what most people see.
Brilliant. So can you like look ahead to see if we're going to have really really bad storms and everything else? Are you better than the BBC, because they get it wrong anyway? I just look out the window and that tells me what's happening for the day. Can you actually see ahead of what's coming? Like if we've got a really bad storm coming.
You can usually tell when there's something going on.
Right.
Usually, in the case of the UK, it's extratropical cyclones. Sometimes they were hurricanes or just formed from whatever. But they usually strike here. We get quite a lot of them, particularly throughout winter.
Right.
But sometimes, every once in a while, we get some severe ones. And obviously, we've got some flooding going on further south as well, which is going on again.
Mm-hmm.
And those are usually caused by them too. So cyclones, in general, affect pretty much everywhere in the world. It's just the different definitions of them.
And right.
I specialise in the tropical regions, the ones down near the equator,
okay,
and the ones which strike places like America and Asia and places like there.
Right, so is this a full-time job that you want to do? Or is it a full-time job that you're doing now?
Well, it's not a job,
right,
necessarily. It's a profession.
Right, yeah.
It takes up a lot of time.
Yeah.
I'll be working on it probably for the foreseeable future, at least. I mean, I have been doing for the past 2 years. It does take up a lot of what I do. I'm going off it just a little bit to allow for a bit more of a personal life.
Yeah.
But yeah, still pretty committed to it.
All right. So since your last interview on Bolton FM, when you was in with with Big H, what's actually happened between that and now?
Okay, well, last time I was here, it was in November when we had the typhoon Haiyan, which pretty much everyone knows about because it made big international headlines when it hit the Philippines. And the videos I made on there, they had, it must have been over, getting towards 150,000 views in total.
That's good, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty impressive, much more than I'd ever thought I'd ever get. So there's a start. And since then, I've been, I was obviously on here, I was on BBC Radio Manchester just the day after.
Mm-hmm.
I believe one of the videos that I did for it was on Dutch television in near the end of November, as part of a charity where they raise money on television, a telethon type thing.
That's good.
And I was also invited to the Northwest Tonight studios to see what goes on there and have a chat about weather.
Brilliant. So where do you go from here now then?
Well, I take each day as it comes.
Yeah, don't we all these days?
Well, that's true. You just don't know what might come around the corner.
Yeah. Okay, and what's the website? Everybody can log on to this website, can't they? See what you're doing and everything else. So tell everybody what the website address is.
So the website is www.force-13.com. So that's force-13.com.
Brilliant, and it's been running for 2 years now. It's just getting better and better and better all the time, isn't it?
Absolutely, and I hope that that will continue.
Yeah, I'm sure it will. It's fascinating stuff. Do you know what I mean? But it just goes over my head. I don't know. If it's raining, it's raining. If it's snowing, it's snowing.
Well, the real skill involved in this is actually putting it out in layman's terms so that everyone can understand it.
Right, brilliant. Okay, so good luck with everything else. Hope that everything runs nice and smoothly for you.
Thank you.
Especially with the website. And it's been nice to catch up with you again, because we like to do that. We like to bring you back in, see how things have progressed and how things have moved on. And it seems that you're doing really, really well. Okay, so what's the weather going to be like for the next week?
I believe it's not looking too good.
No, it's not. Well, I could have told you that.
What do you expect in January?
Well, exactly. Are we going to have any really bad thunderstorms, though? Because we had a really big crash of lightning and thunder yesterday, didn't we?
Well, I didn't see that. I'm from this particular area, so
right.
I might have had a bit different weather. But there's a lot of rain on the way,
yeah.
And it's going to be pretty cold. But there isn't any sign of snow on the horizon. I can tell people that.
Right.
At least not until at least mid-February. And even then, no one really knows what will happen after that.
So no snowmen to be built in the next couple of weeks?
Sure doesn't look like it.
All right, Nathan Foy, we wish you well. Thanks for popping into Bolton FM again.
Thank you.
And it's been nice catching up with you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Nathan.
And that is indeed...
Can you put it on record?
Yes, it's still recording. This was my friend Elaine filming.
If you need someone to do any artistic camera work, I'm your woman. Long as it doesn't involve taking people's clothes off.
Well, there you have it. And this is what goes on in my personal life. I don't know what's going on.
I don't want to do any of that, thank you very much.
Hey. So yes, I'm quite often involved in the world of media. Promoting my site as best I can, and this is the best of Force 13, and hopefully you will see the best of throughout the rest of this show. This filming, at the time of filming, it's the 24th of January, so the actual 3rd of February anniversary edition is coming up a little bit later. So at the moment I don't really know what's going on, but I'm just going to do some filming so people can probably get to know me better a little bit and get to know the project better and what its future is. Now, if you want to if you want to have a say in what the future of Force 13 is, you're definitely welcome to do so, because it's really controlled by you. What do you want to see out there in the next coming months on the Force 13 channel and website? Obviously, I can only work on so much things at a time, so I have to really prioritise in what I do. But, you know, send a message to Force 13, go on the contact form on the website, and contact me, I don't bite. And here's a compilation of every single hypothetical hurricane season that we've gone through. At the time of putting together this video, there have been 67 since last summer. I think the first one began in July. The first one was uploaded back then. And since then, there have been 67 separate requests, and over 30 still on the waiting list as well. So if you are one of those, and if you are one of those in the future, do bear in mind that there is a long waiting list at times, and it isn't always guaranteed that your request will get through. Those of you who happen to request more than one season on your hypothetical request form, you greedy buggers, you may not get both of them done, as you would understand, or at least I would hope you would anyway, because obviously other people would want their first request finished, really, before your second one goes through. If you're interested in helping out with the hypothetical seasons, there is a way you can do that. Just contact me and see if it's for you.
here are the newest hypothetical season animations on the new map. But as you've seen throughout the 67 that you've been sitting through over the past few minutes or so, the format really hasn't changed all that much, and probably won't be doing so, at least not for a considerable time yet. During the Northern Hemisphere off-season, you can submit your own hypothetical Hurricane Season 4 request on the Force 13 website. Just go on force13.com/hypo. There's a lot to making a storm animation, or just an individual storm animation, or a full season animation. A full season animation is what you're seeing right now along the timeline here, which is what it looks like as you're going along in the project and creating these animations. So you can imagine how it takes quite a long time sometimes to get some of your animations complete, some of the ones that you've requested. So of course, if you're submitting a hypothetical Hurricane Season or already have done, please do be patient, because it does take quite a while to get all this sorted for you. For those of you who have already requested or are considering doing so, you might want to consider sending in a tracking map to go along with that, which will prioritise your request in the request list. Obviously that makes my job a bit easier too. Back in April 2013, this video was uploaded to commemorate 500 videos on the Force 13 channel. See how many of these storms that you can identify. There's 500 of them. Now, Force 13 also has a history of creating individual storm-based animations, beginning in 2011, which was pretty much post-storm analysis, what you could call, in the form of an animation, where we had the animation of the storm, where it went, and what sort of damages it caused. You can see here on these very early animations that the design and the actual method in doing it was quite primitive and basic, but those who have been following ever since 2011, when these first ones came out, will know how much it has changed over the 2 or 3 years since the first animations came out. After doing these for a few southern hemisphere storms throughout winter, or the northern hemisphere winter I should say, into 2012, we stopped for a little while and then began doing more animations for individual storms towards the summer when the northern hemisphere warmed up, and this is the result. This one, for instance, was Tropical Storm Florence. Still fairly basic if you compare it to what we have today. This one was also Hurricane Isaac as well. I believe that one had 10 or 11 different updates on that storm, which was quite a lot for the time. And I should also add at this point as well that all these animations, I'm talking over them simply because there was no sound on them for the best part of 2 years before I started narrating and putting music to it around May 2013. So since July 2012 there have been regular updates somewhere around the world. We began in the Western Pacific with Tropical Storm Canoon, I believe it was, the very first storm that had one of these updates. And that was followed not very long later by the whole Northern Hemisphere, which was covered. And then we decided to go for the Southern Hemisphere as well into that winter. So we're covering the whole world and have done ever since summer 2012. This one in particular was update 9 of Hurricane Nadine in the Atlantic, which was of course known for its very long life. I think there were 13 updates in all, one of the most that I've ever done for a single storm. And towards the end of the year with Typhoon Bopa, narrations began on the videos, at least for a short time, and it went through with the next few storms as well before stopping for a while until the bulletins came in 2013. More on that in a moment now. 13, and this storm is currently located at around 75 degrees east, 15 degrees south, with winds of 50 miles per hour and an air pressure of around 989 millibars. The storms and into spring and summer 2013, and we had a bit of a change of format on the general storm animations, but that really changed with the arrival of the tropical weather bulletins, which came just before the end of May 2013, and I know they're very well liked and they remain with us today. And welcome to your tropical weather bulletin for May 26, 2013. It's 6 days until the start of the Atlantic hurricane season, the East Pacific hurricane season already in effect. And at the moment we have 3 invests out in the world at the moment. Invest 91E in the Eastern Pacific, Invest 90C near Hawaii, and Invest 96P down in the Pacific near the Solomon Islands, or Vanuatu actually, isn't it? And looking at the satellite imagery, as you can see, there's all three of them over the Pacific Ocean at the moment. 96P down in the South Pacific, where the season is virtually off limits at this time of year, heading into the winter down there. But 90C and 91E currently going out in the Northern Hemisphere. Looking over towards the Atlantic, not much going on here at the moment yet. As you can see, fairly quiet. Much more sky than there is cloud, as you can see here. Into the Gulf of Mexico, possibly becoming a hurricane along the way, and then making landfall along the Gulf Coast of the United States, probably in Alabama or the extreme western part of Florida, before moving inland and degenerating into a remnant low eventually somewhere over the United States along the East Coast there. But The threat does remain that we may see a hurricane landfall, quite possibly. Hurricane watch is in effect from Grand Isle, Louisiana, to Indian Pass in Florida. So that's pretty much large parts of the Gulf Coast there, Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, and parts of Florida. Tropical storm watches from Grand Isle to Morgan City, Louisiana, as well as metropolitan New Orleans, Lake Moripa, and Lake...
27.3 degrees east, expected to move towards the west-northwest over the next few days as a Category 5 storm, beginning to weaken towards a Category 4, Category 3 eventually as it passes Taiwan and the Philippine Islands, and then eventually reaching...
Now, Signal 4 warning means wind speeds of more than 150 miles per hour. That's definitely expected. In southern and central Taiwan, we also have typhoon warnings there as well, and an orange typhoon warning at the moment for the coast of China. We'll probably be seeing typhoon conditions occurring there very soon. So here are the probability percentages of tropical storm conditions in the Philippines. First of all, you can see how they're higher towards the north, but still, for the parts of northern Philippines, we'll definitely see some tropical storm conditions occurring here, very likely. For the other areas as well, southern Taiwan especially, we'll be seeing some strong winds here, typhoon strength, possibly the case in China as well, but tropical storm conditions extremely likely.
87.7 degrees east, the storm's expected to move towards the northwest, making landfall as a very strong storm along the Indian East Coast. No matter what intensity it will be when it does make landfall, it will be very severe indeed, possibly high-end Cat 4, maybe even a Category 5 landfall. That can't be ruled out at this point. Sustained winds of over 150 miles per hour, certainly possible in parts of Andhra Pradesh and Odisha in India. Those two regions in particular will feel the full force of this storm when it does make landfall along the Indian coastline in around 12 to 24 hours from now.
Left of your image there, the storm moving towards the northwest, making landfall in the Odisha region of India, and then moving inland, moving towards the north, eventually dissipating. And the GFS model, let's see what that one says. That's has a bit more of a further south landfall, just slightly towards the Andhra Pradesh border, making landfall in India and then moving inland at the moment. But that's likely to change as time goes on. The storm heads towards the Japanese islands. These markings here, the red area shows typhoon conditions possible in the next 24 hours. The pink area there shows typhoon conditions possible in the next 48 hours. The orange and yellow is the same things for tropical storm conditions. And you can see no land areas directly under threat at the moment, at least in the next 48
tropical by that point. So this is the latest satellite image. Then you can see how the storm's been moving slowly towards the northwest over the past few hours. The eye slightly shrinking over those past few frames on this floater imagery here. You can certainly see how it's a tight system, a fairly intense one as well. Looks fairly compound, may see some sort of threat from this storm too. So right now, this is the current warnings in effect. Gale advisories for large parts of the Ryukyu Islands, pretty much all of them as a matter of fact. Most of Kyushu under gale advisories as well, and parts of the mainland of Japan also under gale advisories at the moment. Typhoon warnings in effect for Daito Island, which is that small island off to the northeast of the typhoon right now. No warnings in association with Typhoon Lakima just yet, but that may change as time goes on, the storm towards closer towards the northwest. And the Japanese. Update 5 on Super Typhoon Haiyan, which has strengthened over the past 12 hours or so, now with wind speeds of 190 miles per hour sustained, with gusts possibly as high as 230 miles per hour, pressure of 895 millibars, and its current position is 10.2 degrees north, 129.1 degrees east, approaching the Philippines with some venom, certainly the strongest storm we've possibly seen in years, and it will be the strongest landfall we've seen in years as well, with a Category 5 landfall on the cards for the eastern Visayas region. It's certainly going to be a catastrophic storm in that region near the epicenter of the landfall when it does occur in the next 12 hours. The storm will move out to sea over the South China Sea, still as a strong typhoon, and eventually make landfall in Vietnam as a typhoon. So we currently have Signal 4 warnings in effect for most of Samar, Leyte, Northern Cebu, Capiz, Aklan and Northern Antique. Signal 3 warnings in effect for most of the Visayas regions. You can see they're marked in red. Not enough time to go through them on this video. And Signal 1 and 2 warnings in effect for other regions around there as well, towards the north and south of that immediate vicinity. So the probabilities for typhoon conditions in the next 48 hours certainly very high in the eastern Visayas region. I think it's almost a given certainty that we will receive strong typhoon conditions over there, 115 miles per hour or higher, and that may extend further into the western Visayas region as well over the next 24 to 48 hours. This is the latest radar imagery of the storm making landfall in Leyte Island in the past few hours, and you can see how it's began to disintegrate just a little bit, but still an eye quite clearly visible as it moves towards to west-northwest. This is the satellite image where you can see how the eye has cleared Leyte Island now as it moves towards the west-northwest, and it will approach the rest of the Visayas region, probably clipping the very northern extremity of Cebu over the next hour or two, and then begin to move towards the west-northwest, and in about 12 hours' time clear the Philippines. But you can see the central core of that storm is still extremely intense. Though, and after a four-month absence, the tropical weather bulletins returned in January 2014. Tropical weather bulletin number 74, it's January the 11th, 2014, and we currently have two named cyclones out there right now. First of all, Ian in the southern Pacific, right over Tonga right now, as a Category 4 cyclone, and we also have Cyclone Colin, which is a tropical storm equivalent, in the central part of the Indian Ocean right now, not affecting any land areas. We also have three INVESTs out there. INVEST 91W, Category 4 cyclone initially, possibly even intensifying at first into 145 miles per hour, maybe even more than that if it really gets its act together, but weakening is then on the cards after it leaves Tonga, and then will eventually dissipate or turn post-tropical as it moves far towards the southeast out to sea, away from any other land areas. But Tonga right now will probably be receiving the full effects of the storm, or at least part of those islands will. We have a hurricane warning in effect. Now, another feature Force 13 did over the past 3 years was a compilation towards the end of the year called Hurricane Week. Now, it was going to go ahead in 2011, but didn't in the end. And that's before it became Force 13, as a matter of fact. That's just after it was called off, Force 13 itself was formed on November the 30th, but that's by the by. 2012, of course, we had Hurricane Week, and that was the biggest project by far that I'd ever done, and this is it right now, and it was just over 2 hours in length in total.
With a wind diameter of nearly 1,500 miles, a wind speed of 190 miles per hour, and a record-smashing air pressure of 870 millibars, Typhoon Tip of 1979 makes it to number one in my top 100.
Tip formed in the Micronesian region, and after moving erratically for a short while, the storm made its mind up on direction and moved northwest, curving gradually to the west. Tip passed just to the south of Guam and then became a typhoon, strengthening for over a day until it reached Category 5 status and its record low pressure. Tip moved slowly to the northwest, then back to the west, weakening to a Category 4 storm. It maintained that strength for a time before beginning to weaken further, passing Okinawa as a Category 2 storm and striking mainland Japan as a Category 1 typhoon. Flooding and mudslides in Japan resulted in the deaths of 42 on land and 44 at sea, with a fire causing 13 indirect fatalities. Tip's wind field measured nearly 1,400 miles wide, equivalent to half the size of the continental United States, or slightly more than the distance from Taipei to Tokyo. The feature also covered storm summaries from the whole year. This one, Hurricane Sandy, a case in point, throughout 2012. Obviously, it went out in November, so most of the storms from the year were covered in this animation, in this feature. And it lasted for a full 5 days in Hurricane Week 2012 and went on to do 6 days in 2013, which we'll move on to next. Work on the next year's project began all the way back in September 2013, so there were a full 3 months really to work on the project, which was to go out at the end of November. And all that time was needed, and more as it turned out, because there was going to initially be 60 regions covered in the world tropics to be as part of the Hurricane Week, but in the end it had to be cut down to 45, which was everywhere in the Northern Hemisphere. But still, it was an amazing project, and by far the largest one ever undertaken by Force 13, as these following stats will show you. After such a large project, there isn't going to be another Hurricane Week from Force 13 at least, though there may be little features here and there over the coming months that may be interesting, though nothing quite on the scope of Hurricane Week, and that's possibly a good thing because with around 8 hours of content on Hurricane Week 2013, it was quite a lot for even the most biggest Storm fans. Force 13 run two main interactive features. First of all, Predict a Storm, where you can predict all upcoming storms in the Atlantic, Eastern Pacific and the Western Pacific basins, based on criteria such as formation and dissipation dates, intensity, longevity and landfalls. At any time, you can have a quick glance at the homepage of the Force 13 website, scroll down a bit, and you'll find the tables which show you the percentage chance of formation from the homepage. And if it's looking interesting, you can click through to the main submission page, where you can pick your basin for where you think the storm may form, and go ahead and submit your prediction. In this example, you can see that the results page is greyed out because the storm hasn't yet formed. That would change as soon as the storm forms, the storm in question. Even after a storm forms, it's not too late to submit your prediction, but best points are awarded for those who submit just before the storm forms. And those of you who want a little bit of a slower paced competition, you can go for Predict a Season, where you can predict the seasonal storm totals for the Atlantic, East and West Pacific, as well as the North Indian Ocean Basin. The competition is open right the way through until November this year, 2014, from now, the time of the upload, and has been open since December 2013. So you can go ahead and submit any time, but points do dwindle as time goes on, so get your prediction in as early as you can. To get to the Predict the Season page, just go on the interactive section of the website and it should be the first link there. Both of these competitions are just for fun, of course, on the Force 13 website, but it is often interesting to see how things play out in the real world compared to our predictions, so best of luck for those of you who are submitting your predictions now or already have done.
Hello there once again. I'm not in the Force 13 studios at the moment, but I am joined by someone that we know fairly well. Now, he entered the 2012 Predictor Season contest and he won it. But in 2013, well, he didn't quite do as well.
The reasons for that, Nathan, for everyone else out there.
Let's just introduce who you are first, then.
Sorry, yeah, Paul Nugent, previous champion of the world when it comes to predictions.
You know, there were only about 25 people who went in Predictor Season 2012.
Well, how many?
About 25.
And I came top, Nathan, so to me that's top of the world.
Right.
Yeah, the reason, obviously, I wanted other people to have a chance this year, so I purposely, deliberately, overbid myself.
What?
Overbid the storms.
Oh, right, okay. So he ended up coming. Well, I came. I obviously submitted a few predictions. I did about three in total. You can do that if you do it every month. And my best one came fourth. The winner was CES 15 Hurricanes, and I think Spencer came second, if my memory serves me correctly. And Paul came in 31st place. it was out of 240 something, but
well, there we go. So if you take a few times, how many were in last year, and then
right, okay.
So the kind of ratio, I've come probably in the top.
I'm not really convinced with that one. Say you're in the top, what would it have been? The top 5% in the end, or so.
Yes.
Or less than that. Yeah, thank you for nudging up the camera. We don't have a cameraman today.
No.
This is how professional we are sometimes, right?
Yes. Well, that's too serious to be professional, isn't it?
By the looks of things, yes.
which is why I'm not wearing the feathered band.
It's part of my uniform.
No, it's not.
It's just to make people feel relaxed.
If you're to believe that, you can, but I'm not. Meanwhile, yeah, he got 31st, below a lot of people. A lot of people who, the thing is, Predictor Season 2014 is out now, so are you going to enter it?
Absolutely. I am going to come back with a bit of vengeance.
I'll tell you something, should we do it right now?
Okay.
Let's do it.
Right, we're back again.
We're back on the Force 13 website on the Predictor Season 2014 page. Now, there's two ways you can do it this time. The classic method, which is just how it was last year, or you can do it every month, like every month it will refresh with the new month's totals, so you can do it by month. Okay. But I think the classic method is preferable for most people.
Mm-hmm.
You can see already one storm has formed in the West Pacific, one in the North Indian. There could be a second one forming very soon, recording date, January 29th. But what are you going to put in on your predictions?
Right, do I start here, number one?
Yeah, you start there, that's for the Atlantic.
Okay, so last year, I think I put...
I don't actually make that clear that it is the Atlantic there, so I'll have to change that. You'll have to remove the first digits first. Paul doesn't do computers.
Yeah, I'll have to turn the numbers on. Right, so 12 I'm going for.
12 tropical storms in the Atlantic.
Yes. Hurricanes, they're not normally as many, so I'm going to go...
That's just your basis of thinking, is it?
Nine. And major hurricanes, I'm going to go 6.
This year we had, 2013, we had none.
None?
None at all.
No, when I said 6, I'm thinking of 6, I'm thinking maybe 2. Maybe 1.
Ooh, just the 1.
But 9 hurricanes, how many did we have last year?
2013 we had 2.
So I'm going to just think about
that.
That
is a very low number. Yeah. It's the lowest since, when was it, 94 I think.
And tropical storms?
Tropical storms in the Atlantic, we had... I think it was 13 in the end.
That's good. Right, I'm happy with that then.
Quite season.
Right, so is that what I do?
That's just the Atlantic. The next one is the Eastern Pacific.
Which is more vulnerable or less vulnerable?
The Eastern Pacific quite often has more storms, but sometimes it can pull off a quiet season. But I would go... last year I think there were 20, I think.
Okay, I'm going to go 14.
That's interesting. I think we had that the year before.
Yeah. Hurricanes, okay, so with more tropical storms, I'm assuming there's more hurricanes. But I'm going to go with 6 again.
He's gone for 6.
Major hurricanes. I'm going to keep going with my ones. I've got a feeling this year's
really?
Not going to be so good.
Well, there was only one last year, but they are more likely in the East Pacific.
That's my thinking, Nathan.
West Pacific, then the most active basin of the lot, usually. It's very rare that it isn't.
Uh-huh.
20.
Yes.
20. It was 26 last year.
There we go.
9 typhoons.
I'm
sort of helping you out a little bit, but I'm doing it legitimately. I'm not saying what I would go for. I'm saying what happened last year.
And we're telling everyone else.
I'm telling everyone else too, yeah.
Yeah, so major typhoons, and we're going to go for a whopping 2.
Just 2?
No, when I say whopping 2 times 2, it's a whopping 4.
Sorry, I sort of led you into that one as well. Yeah. This is the North Indian Ocean, that's usually a very quiet one.
Quiet, isn't it? Yeah, so normally I would go for about 7.
Mm.
Yeah.
It's fairly active, but it has happened.
15.
It has happened.
Yeah, cyclones, obviously not as harsh, so we're going to go for 3.
3.
Basically, I'm going to go for none.
0 major cyclones.
Yes.
Interesting. We had the 1 last year, and they are fairly rare. It isn't all the time that we get major cyclones over there. So that appears to be Paul's prediction for 2014 predictor season. He's not submitted it yet, but he's about to, so there might be a last-minute change off-camera if he doesn't want everyone to see what scores he's choosing. But there he is.
Submitted. No, I'm not going to let you see what my final number was. Fill in your name.
What happened there?
I don't know.
Dear, we'll sort this one out. You submitted it on the wrong one.
Oh,
gotta press that button up there. Gotta click off that first.
Nathan, anyone would think I don't know what I'm doing.
You don't know what you're doing?
No, it's not.
Why isn't it?
I don't know.
Oh dear.
First. Have I used
you see, this is what happens when my technology doesn't work. I have no idea.
Obviously, being a computer guru, I might have sorted this issue out.
He's a computer guru.
Yeah.
Oh, he's done it as well.
into...
Well, evidently, that little issue is going to have to change when I get back home this evening. So by the time you watch this video, that problem will not happen. You know, people will be ROFLing at their desks right now.
Would I have just submitted the bottom one, yeah, not the top one?
No, it did them both.
It did them both.
Well,
even though I haven't.
That's how it does it, yeah, it does them both. But obviously, when I look at it, I just look at the one you predicted, okay. The one that you submitted.
Is that us done?
That's you done.
Right, well, good luck to everybody else. I hope you give me a bit of competition this year, as you did last year. But I'm feeling very confident that I will be back to my usual number one. World.
Well, Paul has joined the already 30 or so people who have submitted this season for 2014. There were about 242 last year or somewhere along those lines. Fairly impressive compared to the like 25 the year before. So if you fancy a bit of a challenge, go for it. 2014 predictor season.
Come
just
on.
Go on the yeah, interactive yeah. section. Of the Force 13 website, and you should find it fairly easily enough on there. I'll make sure that the entry fields are all fixed. Because that shouldn't happen, where you submit your name and then it says submit a name.
Can I just say, I look forward to seeing two of you on the podium. Thank you.
Two?
That first, second, third.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Goodbye.
Yeah. I'm just one supposed to saying that. You see, this is what happens. People try to barge in with their... It's like television almost, where people... I want to get on.
Yeah, but in my predictions, I was champion once.
I've got to submit mine yet. And no one's seen what mine are yet.
You see mine, I think you always ask me first, and then you do yours after.
Well, why did I come fourth last year and you 31st?
Where did you come in for?
I came... I don't know what... I don't remember.
Right, well, I came first. Have you ever came first?
No.
So, I was supposed to get to...
Why? But I've come first on Predictor Storm.
When?
And you've never entered Predictor Storm.
Well, that's why I've never come first. Facebook.
Oh, shut up. This is the sort of stuff that goes on here. Right. I don't even know what the camera's looking at, but there you have it. Just leave us to it, will you? I've been given the feathered headband, so it appears that I'm now wearing it. And that concludes Force 13's best of feature with myself and Paul, which has just come into his office right. Behind me. And it was fantastic having your company watching this hour of
madness.
Yes. February the 3rd, Force 13 is 2 years old, the website is at least. The channel's been going a little bit longer, November 30th, 2011. Let's have a party!
There are two particular features coming up on Force 13 in the next few months. The Southern Hemisphere Cyclones video on March 31st. That's pretty much the other quarter of Hurricane Week 2013, which is finishing off in the Southern Hemisphere. On March 31st towards the end of their seasons, and Cyclone Education Week from April the 21st to the 25th, covering all you need to know about tropical cyclones and a little bit more history on the side as well. But what's more is that a lot of this will be on location in southern Florida in April, so look forward to that one as well. The main place for all your storm information is on the website force13.com, which is updated quite regularly every single day, at least when I'm at the computer. And we're also on four other means now, the video sharing means, YouTube and Dailymotion. Just search Force 13 on either of those, and on the social platforms as well, Facebook and Twitter. Just search Force 13 on both of those mediums as well, and constantly updated on all five platforms. So whichever one you prefer, or all of them if you wish, please do so, and you can get in touch through either of those means as well.